Greetings, this is Wasteland. Welcome back to Let's Play Torment Tides of Numenera, where apparently I hit a bug. These guys that was over here just disappeared. I rested last time, they were still here, I saved, closed the game, and now I'm in the game again and they are not here. Which is really weird, because how the hell do you actually rest now? I don't know. That's... I don't know. We'll see, I guess. 5, 1, 4, 3. Man, that's a weird bug. Also, the audio is kinda still broken. Okay. Again, I'm not sure why these guys disappeared. Hopefully, we won't pay for it.
That's something I could do.
And I can actually rest again.
Let's go.
Plus 4 damage, plus 1 damage per effort applied, damn. Healing and endurance skill, that's not bad actually. You already have plus 3 damage though. And I don't care about the healing, but endurance. Endurance, I do care. You have no artifacts. Let's try that. Why is the audio so all over the place? Do I have it on? No, there is no option actually. I thought maybe I have it on surround or something and I'm using my headphones, but... I don't think this is it. There's something weird going on depending where you are and how you look.
Of course.
Like it's on surround, I don't know.
I'm gone.
Well, there is a lot of loot. Is that a diamond? Maybe.
All right.
All right, let's see. I see some people, let me save somewhere.
Without doubt.
Oh, that's nothing.
Naturally.
Alright, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Something blocked. Oh. These are the people I saved, I think. Just moved the screen? That was weird. Still don't know why he pushed him. Maybe it was an accident. Probably not. Maybe these aren't the guys I was... I don't know. I don't remember the guys I saved, so... I think they were memorialists. The other fellow is Narov. He tries to hurt people, but it never turns out right. What? I don't hurt people. Ah, he thought I hadn't noticed. How stupid does he think I am? Oh yeah. So these are the same. That's so weird. I just totally moved while I saved and loaded. It was Narv trying to kill me again. I don't blame him though, it's all for the best. What? What does that mean? Meanest bastard this world has seen, except he keeps messing it up somehow.
Without doubt.
They should do something about the effects. The effects are way too high. That constant humming we have around us, I think it's the aura or the fetal. And everything else is too low. I am a villain, the worst villain you'll ever meet, and by that I mean that no matter what I try to pull, somehow ends up helping people. Okay. So he tries to kill all of them, and totally fails. Why are you trying to kill them? Can I ask that? No. Too bad.
Yes.
Alright, let's see. I'm guessing we're going some form of teleporter.
I'm ready to become even more heroic!
I'll remember that.
I totally did that on random. My bad. Alright, let's see. Let's do Namja, which is 4135. And they should be the memorialists. Whoa. Ah, the sound stopped. So maybe it isn't from us, something else. Okay.
Let's go.
Zahir El Sami. Kenneth Holm Tronrod. Rick Arnold. That's weird.
I'm going.
His fight came to an abrupt end with the realization that truth is irrelevant. All that matters in society is belief. Those that see the truth outside accepted beliefs can suffer in silence or cry out in futility one last time before they disappear. Peter the Wonder Goth. What the hell?
Yes.
What am I doing with this? This is some cast of smearcaster. Floral milkcasters, okay. Beautiful, beautiful Namja, a casualty of a war that she had nothing to do with. 4 years, what the hell? Let's save first. Hums and throbs in your hand, although you hear no music, you realize your lips are mouthing the words of a song in a language you don't speak. Let's go inside. The woman's name is Sikia. Her skin turns red when she's afraid, a mutation. Red is the color of her blood running from her gas in her forehead. Red is your rage as you look at the two men who towered over her, laughing raucously, taking turns to vent their spite. Human rights, Muti, one of them jeers. There ain't enough water to go around, but this troll's poor thinks he deserves more than the rest of us. Sikia starts to protest that it wasn't here, but the human kicks her in the face. You all do it, he spits in her face. Don't think we ain't seen every one of you taking more than your daily cup. What the fuck is wrong with you guys? Okay, and now they beat us. Damn mutants, you don't belong here. What the fuck is wrong with these guys? I want to say, you know, humans. So that's what's wrong with them, I guess. It's not like that's really far off in real life as well, so... What are we going to do? Series of pain. Looks pretty bad. You know what I miss? You obviously half days as he speaks. Your music. You used to write the most motivating or moving songs. I miss your songs. We should fight the boy grins with sharp yellow teeth. There are lots of us. We can take them. Hassiled. Damn. Anyway, don't listen to him. We're not fighters. You know that. I think we should just keep our heads down. But that won't stop this, will it? No, it won't. Can't take much more of this, I mean all of us. Seems like someone comes in here causing trouble every week now. As if life in the morphing grotto weren't hard enough. What we should do is talk to the Burgrave. He might be actually able to do something. Not that he would. Not that any of us could ever get to him without trouble. This guy is really big and strong, but he didn't actually help at all. Zell will not feast until blood has come to rain, he says, and you realize he's talking about himself. Not that he makes any sense. Zell desires blood to rain. What the hell does that mean? I guess I can try to go get help from Burgrave. Who the hell he is, I'm not sure, but we'll see. The tower marks the center of the town square. It is clearly not of the ninth world. The Burgrave is easy to find. He stands in front of the tower, a stout man in a colorful robe, more colorful than most Zerboan citizens. Okay. What brings a mutant out here? You state your case, telling him of the attacks. Your injuries tell me even more than your words, he says. I'm surprised you waited so long to tell me. Very well, I will have the matter investigated. I serve the grotto too, no? You thank him and return home. I guess maybe I shouldn't have waited. You think you can use the same trick twice? The Burgrave is in his tower and you are alone in the dark alley. Ain't nobody going to care about you. Okay, and they kill us. That was... damn, harsh. What happened? Alright, you know what? Let's try that again and see if we can get something else. Okay, same things basically. Try that again. I want to see if it matters if you... Oh, it doesn't matter. Okay. That's interesting. I'll keep the first save, I just want to see if there is actually any difference in this or not. Sing to inspire them. Yeah, sure. That's a nice song. Every mutant stands ready with wave-shift clubs and kitchen knives. This is worse than before. It's not just two thugs, but the entire gang of humans. The fighting begins faster than you expect. Tiki and Miss are taking care of themselves, but the others are in serious trouble. As many mutants have died, the grotto has killed more humans. They are pressed back out of the grotto, and the noise soon draws the attention of more Zerboans. Some of these join the fight against the mutants, but many more stand alongside mutants, defending them. Something slams into your back then. Before you can turn to face your attacker, another blow smashes your head in the dirt. Life seeps from your skull. Some distance away you see Zell lying dead on the ground as well. You hear the fighting spread, a full riot. Never again will the grotto be ignored. I like that result better actually. Okay, we'll keep that one. Dominant tides have shifted. Gold, okay. I will get back to blue soon enough. Cool. Alright, do we have anything else in here? No, this music is pretty fucking good. I'm not sure why it's so low, but... Oh, and I got the whole... back again. Alright, let's try... 3, 5, 4, 3. Now it's off. I think it's a bug. The sound. Who knows? Go. What is this face all about? Callistids. I would like to uncover this thing's secrets. It must require tuning. The head of each string is attached to a small bead. Each bead is made of a different metal. Okay. I'll take the 100%.
I'm ready to become even more heroic.
I'm all leveled up. I believe I know a melody or two we can play. The sound is unearthly crystalline. It shivers through your bones. After a few holding notes, Callistids has the sense of the instrument and plays a holding melody in a minor key. She lifts her hands from the strings and steps away from the instrument. Nothing happens. How this she begins. The strings harden, completely humming. Above them hovers a welter of confusing lights and images. You can't even look at it, some sort of spatial or temporal distortion. Then Callistus places a hand on your shoulder, and for the moment you see as he does. The image slides into focus along the realities. Together, the whispers will solve it. I'm not even expending effort, just get 100%. That's so good. Those kills. With Callistus' hand on your shoulder, the image snaps into a clear focus. You see an intricate image. With flickering lights that seem to indicate data and measurements projected into the air. You realize that these images and measurements project through realities, through dimensions, and you have a momentary glimpse into Callistus' everyday perspective. Probabilities coil around you, and it is only through the power of your shared mind that you can make sense of what you are seeing. It's a schematic. For what? You recognize one of the many devices your sire had hidden away under Siku's cliffs. In this image, however, it's surrounded by a series of sharp lines, one of which is bisecting an unrecognizable figure. By comparison, the towers are surrounded by concentric circles in which the figures remain whole. The tips of the towers reach the third concerting ring around the world, while the tines only reach the first. I have no idea. At the center here, there is what looks like the ninth world. But these other images, machines, nanobots, the data sphere. And if this image is correct, yes, under the proper circumstances, I will be able to make a connection. The question is when and where I will be able to make this connection. It implies a willing biological construct. I am one step closer to understanding the data sphere. You have progressed one step further than your sire ever came. You should be proud, dear. You have just surpassed your creator. If you say so.
Danger awaits!
Ha ha! Alright, skirmish spectacle. Whenever Eretis lands a critical hit with a melee weapon, confer dazed to all enemies in immediate range. Damn, nice. And we can pick. We can pick only one of these. Hook, one might. Snare a target with a grappling hook and pull them towards you. Nice. When you kill an enemy, immediately make the bonus attack. Ooh. Damn. This is good. This is also good. Is he using heavy? I think he's using heavy, right? Yeah, it is heavy. Okay. Cool. We did something which only Callistus got, basically.
In an instant.
I wonder if this is a bucket or something. This seems kinda something like that. Anyway, I'll end the episode here and we'll try the third and last combination I have. For now, thank you for watching. As usual, feel free to leave a comment if you want to, subscribe if you haven't, press the like button, always helps, and I will see you next time with more Torment Tides of Numenera.